I get it. I got a few hours break, so I thought maybe there was something I could do. I'm so sorry.
I know.
Sit down. Come on. Oh, it shouldn't have happened, Bobby. We were so close to getting away.
I know.
I'm so angry about what happened to him. And Victor Jerome is just walking around free.
My blood turns cold every time that man passes by.
He's been at the hospital?
Yeah. Look, I'm sorry. I shouldn't have even brought it up.
But why has he been at the hospital?
Olivia's being released under the care of a psychiatric nurse.
Oh, God. How ironic. She should be set free the day after.
Listen, don't think about her right now.
She's going back to New York, isn't she? She's going back to New York.
Anna, you don't need this right now.
Well, where's she going?
Port Charles Hotel.
She's staying here in Port Charles?
Well, legally she has to. She's still under... Look, I'm sorry I brought it up. Just try not to upset you, okay?
I'm not upset.
Right now, you should be thinking about yourself and about Robin.
Yeah, I know.
Hi. Hi, Bobby.
Hi, Ellen.
You know what? I wouldn't mind having that bath right now.
Oh, now you're talking, chum.
Okay, you don't mind, do you, Bobby?
No, of course not. I just came by to...
Okay.
...let you know I'm your friend and you don't have to go through this alone.
Oh.
Yeah.
You take care of my day, Bobby.
Okay.
Oh, I'll see
you.
Thanks for coming. Bye.
Okay, chum. I'll run the water for you back now.
I should do something.
Roberts.
Carver.
Sean Donnelly.
How do you do?
Heard a lot about you, Donnelly. WSB, right?
Yeah, but this one's personal.
Well, this is Agent Malone. He was one of the agents who was with Duke last night. I caught the first shuttle up from New York when I heard. I can't tell you how upset I am by what happened.
Wait a minute. I was to understand that Duke went into the warehouse with someone else. There were only one agent, right?
Agent Russo. Right. We'd switched positions for security reasons.
Where the hell were you?
At the safe house. My part in the plan was through. I left for New York. I don't understand what happened. Everything was going so smoothly.
Yeah, well, something screwed up, and I intend to find out what.
Well, I'd like to help. Any way I can.
What have you got so far, Robert?
All we know is that Jerome organized the hit.
Well, that's the easy part. The hard part's going to be proving it.
Yeah, well, we better. Otherwise, your entire witness protection program's going to be in the toilet.
Yeah. Well, apparently somebody from Victor Jerome's organization got wind of our plan. And we need to identify them all.
We get him. We get Jerome.
Could it be someone in your organization?
I'd hate to think so.
Well, it had to be someone who had access to the plan. Now, were there any new people in on this? Any new agents? Someone you didn't know?
You'd know that better than me, Carver.
No, they were all experienced men.
All right. Then you tell me how Lavery knew this whole thing was a trap.
What? I don't understand. He knew?
The plan was the Duke and this agent, what's his name?
Russo.
Russo were to enter the warehouse inconspicuously. Now, that being the case, what in the hell was Lavery doing seen running down the street screaming about a trap and calling for Anna?
I wasn't aware of that.
I have no idea.
You know, Malone, you said that you were at the safe house just before Russo and Duke left, right?
That's right.
Okay, did anything unexpected happen? Anything that could have made Duke suspicious?
No. Carver called me at the appointed hour and gave me the green light. I told Duke and Russo it was safe to go, and they left.
Is that right?
Yeah, I called them and said it was safe to go, yeah.
All right, anything else that you can add to that, Malone?
No, sir. Just that I hope you find out who did this.
We will. You can go, thank you.
Thanks, Malone.
Thank you.
Malone was guarding Duke right from the start, correct?
Yeah, Malone was the agent in charge of the operation.
But why the hell did Russo take Duke to the warehouse and not Malone?
Well, now that's standard operating procedure. We like to make random changes in our personnel and timing to throw off anybody who might be looking for a pattern, a schedule in our movements.
Well, someone sure had access to it because those explosives had to be set well in advance.
Any other agents we can talk to in this thing?
Yeah, I've got more on the way over right now.
Good. Because I want to talk to everybody concerned with the witness protection program.
You think that's where the mole is?
Mole or rat? This whole thing stinks of an inside job. I'm going to find out who's involved and trap him.
Duke knew it was a trap. Why didn't he call Anna? Why would he risk the chance of her showing up at that warehouse?
Probably because he just found out.
All right. What about the agent that was with him?
No. Couldn't have been Russo.
Oh, come on. Why not? The man shows up the last minute. He goes to the warehouse with Duke.
He's also dead.
You think of a better way for Victor to cover his track?
Oh, Regis, you're here. Good. Come on in. Robert, Sean, this is Agent Regis. Hi. Sean Donnelly, Robert Scorpio.
Hi.
Regis was the man to drive Duke and Russo to the warehouse.
I want to know what went in the car on the way to the warehouse. Now, did you overhear anything that Russo and Duke said to each other?
Mr. Lavery was really upset.
About what? Exactly what did he say?
He kept telling me to drive faster. Russo was trying to calm him down, you know, persuade him to be a little more careful, but Duke wasn't listening. He said he had to stop Anna, that she didn't know that there was a change in the rendezvous point.
Well, wait. What made him think there was a change in the rendezvous point?
All he said was that Malone told him that there was a change in the rendezvous point.
Wait, Caliber, what's this? I mean, what the hell is this change in the rendezvous point? I didn't know anything about that.
I didn't make any changes. I gave Malone the green light.
Bloody hell, it's Malone.
It has to be.
Damn. I'm going to have my men pick him up. He's probably on the way to the airport.
Why the airport?
Well, because that's where he's supposed to be, at our New York headquarters.
Miss Victor's got some other travel plans for him. Put out an APB, airport, and bus terminals.
You got Regis, you come with me. We'll get some in and we'll check out other places he might be in Port Charles.
Try the waterfront.
Father.
Later.
Commissioner.
Not now, Scott.
How about a little legal lynching party for Victor Jerome?
Get to the point.
Duke Lavery's death. Jerome's behind it.
Tell me something I don't know.
You supply the rope. I'll help you hang him.
Okay. But let's get one thing straight. This is my case. And I'm not helping you to make any points with the DA's office. I want this killer and I want him bad.
I'm the guy for the job.
Sit down, let's compare notes.
How about Ann and Robin? It's going to be really rough on them.
Won't be easy. I'm going to drop by as soon as we conclude our business.
Could be one tough day.
Especially when she finally figures that he's dead. I'm not quite sure how she's going to react to that.
Dr. Eileen's hurting.
Olivia Jerome left letters.
Well, she's just about to leave.
Is she still in her room?
Yes, 8th floor.
Excuse me, where is Mrs. Lavery going?
Who?
The woman you were just talking to.
Oh, she was asking about Olivia Jerome, so I sent her up to the 8th floor.
Hello, Olivia. I bet you're excited to be leaving here.
Oh, I am. I mean, thank you for all your help and everything, but I just can't wait to get home.
You do remember, sweetheart. You can't go home yet.
I know.
But I found you a lovely suite at the Port Charles Hotel.
Are you going to stay with me?
I'll have to go back to New York, but you'll have your nurse, Nora, with you all the time.
And you'll need to be close by for your therapy sessions with me.
You do realize, Mr. Jerome, that according to the court order, Olivia only has limited freedom of movement, and she must have her guard with her at all times.
Officer, Nora is my daughter's nurse, and yes, I'm very familiar with the conditions of my daughter's release.
Excuse me. Here's your list of therapy sessions. It's important she doesn't miss any of them.
Contact the lab. Do you think I'll be able to get my mummy back, Dr. Harvey?
Well, let's hope so.
Oh, that would be nice.
Right.
There's Linda Gamp.
Well, you make sure you keep up those therapy sessions.
Well, I will.
Very important. Again.
Victor.
It's very important.
Oh, Anna, I heard about Duke. I'm
I
so sorry.
I want to thank you for the roses.
Anna, what is the meaning?
Before you having to kill me and my daughter last night as well.
Anna, what are you talking about?
Get away from me. Stay out of this.
No, you let her talk, stay doctor. She's had a shock.
I know you didn't dirty your hands, but you gave the orders, didn't you? And I had to stand
Anna,
there and watch.
Anna.
Do you have any idea how that feels, Victor? I had to stand there and watch as my husband was killed.
You sure, Anna? I had nothing to do with it.
Yes, you did. You liar.
I swear, Anna, as sure as I'm standing here. Come on, let's go. Anna, please, this is not the place. Anna!
You're gonna die. Hey.
Anna, no.
I gotta get you, Victor Jerome, for the last thing I ever do. Ever.
I knew you'd like it.
Yeah. Will that be all, Mr. Jerome?
Yes, thank you very much, son. Hopper, did you talk to the hotel florist like I told you?
Yes, there'll be fresh flowers every day, sir, and meal arrangements have been made with the hotel.
Perfect. Oh, sweetheart, I set up charge accounts for you at, I think, every single store in Port Charles, huh? You get whatever you need.
Oh, thank you. I need a new outfit for the opening.
Open? Olivia, what opening?
My art gallery, silly. It opens this week.
Will that be all, Mr. Jerome?
Hopper, leave us alone for a while, will you?
Yes, sir.
I am so excited, I have to tell you. Julian said he was going to bring over some Cheryl...
Will there be
something. And who is Duke Lavery?
What?
Is that Mrs. Lavery's husband?
Olivia, enough. We're alone. The nurse can't hear us from where she is.
Well... Mrs. Lavery was very upset, and I thought maybe something happened to her husband.
Sweetheart, look at me. You honestly don't know who Duke Lavery is?
No. Should I?
Call the pharmacy.
Nurse Krupnik, please call the pharmacy.
I got it.
Yes, you most certainly did.
How about a kiss for the next district attorney?
No, listen to me. We gotta talk, okay? It's important.
Did you hear what I said on the phone? I got the case.
I heard what you said, okay? You gotta give the case to somebody else.
Give the case to... Oh, come on. You're not still afraid of Victor Jerome, are you?
You bet I am, and you should be too. Duke, come on, the things. Come on.
Listen to me. This case is the most important thing in my career.
I know that, and I want you to be district attorney. I really do, but you've got to take safe, sane cases, okay?
Safe? Nobody gets any place in life if they don't take a couple of little risks now and again.
And nobody gets anywhere going against Victor Jerome. You know that. You've seen what he can do. He did it to you.
No, Victor Jerome doesn't bother me. He's got nothing on me. Everything has been given back to the guy. You understand something? I couldn't be in the district attorney's office if I was taking bribes.
All right. It's just
now, look. I am going to get something on Victor Jerome. If that bothers you, well, that's too damn bad.
Well, I am just trying to be damn sensible, okay?
Sensible. Cow down to a guy like Victor Jerome? Are you crazy? This case is going to make my career. And if you don't think I'm going to take advantage of it, you got some screws loose up here.
Excuse me. Have you seen this man recently? His name's Malone.
Nope.
Sorry.
Yeah.
So, got any wood type?
Hello, Malone.
Hey, Regis.
Thought you went back to New York.
I had some business to do here first.
I'm glad I caught you. Carver and Scorpio want to see you. They got a few questions they want to ask you.
Sure. Let's go. What are we doing down here anyway?
Come on.
Victor, it's Malone. They're on to me.
What do you mean they're on to
you? I'm down on the docks. One of the witness protection guys spotted me, said Carver and Scorpio wanted to talk to me again. I'm telling you, they know.
You should have left the country right after Lavery's death, like I told you.
Yeah, well, you better help me. If Scorpio starts asking me questions again, there's no telling what I might say or who I might implicate.
Take it easy, Malone. Of course I'm going to help you. I won't leave you swinging in the wind. I tell you what, you'll be at Pier 15 in half an hour.
Yeah, well, then what?
Just relax, Malone.
I always take care of my people. You just trust me now. Hopper. Malone is going to be at Pier 15 in half an hour. I want you there ahead of him. It seems our friend has gotten himself into an awkward situation. You'll help him out of it, won't you?
Station down.
Yes.
Anywhere from the airport?
No, Malone hasn't been spotted anywhere yet.
Oh, come on, guy. We can't let this guy get away now.
I'm thinking about
Scorpio.
It's Regis.
What happened? Where are you?
I'm in a dock near Water Street. I found Malone. I tried to bring him in, but he must have suspected.
You all right?
Yeah, just a little groggy.
Stay right there.
We'll be down. Regis spotted Malone on Water Street. Check it out, all nearby areas, all right?
You got it.
We've got him.
Well, let's hope we get him before Victor does.
Just need to calm down, okay?
Oh, stop telling me to calm down, please. Victor murdered my husband because he testified against him. That's the truth. That's it, Tom.
But Anna, Robert and the police will handle that. Right now, you have more important things to take care of.
What's more important than that?
Robin.
He'd have killed her, too, if he'd had the chance.
How did Robin handle Duke's death?
Tom.
Hmm?
She's very upset, obviously, naturally.
Well, that means she's going to need you. Look, Hannah, it's very difficult for an adult to understand how something like this could happen. It's even worse for a child.
She was there, Tom. She loved him so much.
She's got to be strong. If she sees you falling apart, she's going to be more frightened than ever.
I don't think I have that strength.
Yeah, the strength to come down here.
Oh, yeah. I was angry.
Well, anger is a natural part of grief. The longer you hold on to it, the harder it's going to be to let go. You got to face it and let it go.
Let it go. What do I have left after that? Nothing.
You have your friends. Most of all, you have Robin.
What's gonna happen to her?
Tell you what. Why don't you go home and get some rest, huh? See Robin?
Yeah. I might take a walk. In my head. Thanks.
Anytime you need me, I'll be here, all right?
Guys, at Malone.
Going somewhere, Malone? We just want to talk to you, that's all.
Malone, down!
Damn him.
You okay?
Yeah, I owe you one, buddy.
Malone?
Come on.
Doesn't look good, Robert.
Did Jerome get you to get Lavery? Come on, talk to me.
Robert, it's no use.
Mr. Jerome.
Robert.
Robert!
He's dead. He's dead.
Some time to get to know each other a little better, you know, when Robin's away.
I'd like that.
Good. It's a deal?
Yes, it's a deal. I must go.
Will you give Robin a farewell gift from me?
Yes, of course.
Goodbye kiss.
Run off, but Sean...
That would be Sean Donnelly?
That's right. Sean stopped him.
And then what happened?
It was a brief struggle. Malone drew a gun. The gun was thrown clear, but he managed to get possession of it first.
So he was going to shoot Sean, Mr. Donnelly?
I believe that's what would have happened, yes.
So in actuality, you had no choice but to shoot the man, is that right?
Yes.
How nice of Mr. Scorpio to handle our problem for us.
Investigation of Lavery's death is ongoing and is confidential.
Well, surely you've heard the rumors, Commissioner, that Mr. Lavery's death was a reprisal for his testimony against Victor Jerome. Can you confirm that?
No comment.
This is Tiffany Hill reporting to you.
Olivia, what are you doing up? You're supposed to be resting. Sweetheart, what is it? Why are you crying?
Why do they keep saying that you killed Duke Lavery?
Hey, baby. Oh, look, a lot of people are jealous of us and of our family, so they spread lies about me. But you mustn't pay attention to them.
I'll try.
You just get well. After all, you're the apple of my eye. Remember? Mr. Hopper and I, we have to go out for a while, but I'll be back shortly. All right?
All right.
Nora's here if you need anything. Listen, you don't pay attention to what people say.
Okay.
If you did kill Duke Lavery, Daddy, I'll make you pay.
I wanted to take Malone alive. He was
my best link yet to Victor.
So this is it, then?
No. Just makes it harder.
Victor should have to pay for this.
It's over for you and Robin. You're safe.
We're safe, because in Victor's twisted little mind, Duke has paid for our crimes. And that's disgusting.
He cared for the both of you. Now he'd want you to get on with your lives. So what are you going to do?
Duke is dead. And the man who is responsible for that is walking around free in the streets, and I'm not going to let it end like this. Victor owes me for the life of my husband.
I'll get him, Anna. The law will get him.
I don't want justice. I want revenge. I think Olivia and Victor should pay for what they've done to me.
What about your daughter?
Do you know how much she wanted a little brother or sister? Do you know how much she loved Duke?
I'm not talking about that aspect of it. But how can you help her when you're so full of hate?
I'm never going to have his child, Robert. I don't have anything left of him.
I know that. Just think about that little person in the next room who needs your help right now, huh?
Oh, I am being selfish. And to her, and to you, to everybody.
Nothing selfish about all three of us trying to row the boat in the same direction.
I know. But you've got yourself to think about. You've got your own life to lead, haven't you?
Well, yes. Catherine's been a bit of a help in that direction of late.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe Catherine and Robin should see more of each other. They've become very good friends. I think they're good for each other.
Good idea. Plus, it might help distract her from Paul.
Oh, really? Do you still have your doubts about that man?
Let's just say I have serious doubts about that man.
How are Robin and Anna doing?
Oh, they're bearing up a run, I guess.
Well, can't be easy for you either.
I'll be all right. Don't worry about me.
What's bothering you?
No, I've been going over it all day. Been reminding myself that guy was responsible for Lavery's death. He'd have killed Sean, too. Sure of that. But hey, let's sit back there, brother. But, you know, I wouldn't have to... look his wife in the eye. She's got one. She's an innocent. Just like Anna's an innocent. Innocent bystander. But I bet she's going through her own little moment of hell right now. And it's not even so much that I... mind that Malone is dead. I just wish he could have done it in his sleep. Oh. That is so good.
Says sources allege that this wasn't the first time Lavery's mob connections have brought grief to his family. His criminal past forced his wife, former Port Charles police chief Anna Devane, to give up a promising career. It is also a well-known fact that his cavalier flirtation with the underworld has frequently endangered the life of his stepdaughter, Robin Scorpio. Well, that does it. You know, I have been planning for a long time to do an editorial series about this stupid excuse for a fish wrap. I'm telling you, I'm going to have my entire investigative team on it tomorrow, and we'll just see how they like it if they're on the other side of this mudslinging thing. It's absolutely ridiculous.
Well, honey, you better make it fast, because I think Angel and I have more direct plans in mind, right?
I'm right.
Well, I think we're all missing the point. What if Anna and Robin hear about it? We already did.
Oh, Anna, we didn't mean, listen, little lady, they're all lies. They've no right to talk about Duke like that.
and also hurting you. You've already been hurt. Just trust an old angel here, okay? I'm going to take all their words and shove them right down their throats.
No, I don't want anybody to do anything. I don't want to be associated with that filth.
Oh, Anna, come on. You have to answer this garbage. You just can't let it pass.
I intend to answer it, but with dignity. You decided that there will be a memorial service for Duke. I'll tell everybody what kind of a man Duke Lavery was. Hi. Thanks for coming over. Thanks for
coming. Oh, you're welcome. I'm really sorry.
I know.
I get one too?
Oh, you bet you do, sweetheart.
Did you like my Uncle Duke?
Of course I did. I think everybody did.
Did you think he was a good person?
Your Uncle Duke was a very good man, yes. Why do you ask?
Well, when you were on television, Everyone said that Colton Shore always told the truth. That newspaper told bad stuff about Duke. Is it true what they said?
No. Not if they said anything bad about Duke. And you know what? You don't have to take my word for it. If you want to know the truth about your Uncle Duke, you look it up yourself.
In the newspaper?
Mm-mm. No, someplace. It's a lot more important than that. You look right in there. That's where you keep all the reasons that you love Duke. And you can always trust your heart.
Thank you. I knew you'd tell me the truth. I'm going to put this where it belongs, in the garbage.
I wouldn't miss this for the world.
I'm going with you.
Yeah. You don't have to do that. That's okay.
I know I don't have to do that. It's the only place in town I get great coffee.
Go on. I will. Yeah, I will.
Hey.
I just can't believe he's really dead.
This old-fashioned idea about men not crying. So why don't you just shed a few for me?
I hate to be a clingy female, you know. And I don't want to tell you not to do what you love to do, even though I know it's dangerous. But let me tell you, don't you ever die on me. Don't you ever get killed because I couldn't stand it.
Lavery and I fought over the years. God knows we fought. But he loved Anna. He loved her a lot, and that meant something to me. She deserved someone who had that much to give.
As much as you'd like to have given?
I don't know. But it worked for the both of them.
What's going to happen with Anna now?
She'll survive. So will Robin.
Yeah. They're both lucky to have you.
They got a lot of people. A lot of people out there that love them. But the key person's gone. I guess Anna is strong enough to get over it. Robin young enough to forget it. Damn it, they just shouldn't have to.
When people die, can they
course, even more so, darling.
Do you think Uncle Duke knows that I still love him?
Yeah, he knows.
I bet Daddy's real sad, too. Do you think it's too late to call him?
No, I think he'll still be up. Why don't you tell him about the plans for the service? Do you want to do that?
Yeah. I'm sure he'll like him. And I also want to tell him that I love him.
Mm-hmm.
Just like I told Duke at my prayers. You know, prayers are like telephone calls you make in your heart.
Mm-hmm.
Should I call him now?
Yeah, go on. Did you forget the number?
No.
Something wrong?
Yeah.
Well, you want me to dial?
No, it's okay. I just have to get ready first. I don't want Daddy to hear me cry.
If it's important or something.
I'll only answer it on the agreement that you will negotiate for your continued presence in my house. At least think about it. Scorpio.
Hello, it's me.
Me who?
Robin, your daughter.
Oh, that me.
I just wanted to see how you were doing.
I'm always fine when I'm talking to you.
And I guess I was a bit lonely.
Yeah, I know. How's your mother?
Lonely, too. Sad.
You give her my love.
I think it'd be even better if you talked to her yourself.
Okay, put her on.
Hi.
Hi. Robin's taking this rather hard.
She's a very brave small person.
Gets that from her mother.
Oh, I don't know, not lately.
Oh, I don't believe that for a second.
When are we going to get the good times back again?
Well, not for a while, I guess, but they'll be back.
Everybody keeps coming over, you know, all our friends, and oh, I don't know, I just feel so empty and just empty.
You know, you're never going to be empty while I'm around.
I know. I love you.
I love you too.
You want to say goodnight? Yeah, Robert wants to say goodnight.
My pleasure.
Daddy?
Mm-hmm.
When you see Catherine, will you tell her that I'd like to visit with her?
Well, why don't you tell her yourself? It looks like she, I'll have to tell her for you. You have to leave.
Daddy?
Yeah.
I love you.
Love you too, sweetheart. Scorpio, looks like you're finally blind.
Yeah, maybe.
No way.
way could I make it through this day without you dudes here to help me?
Oh,
I owe you more than I can ever pay.
Oh, don't be silly. At times like this, all you want to do is help, and we could find something to do.
Yeah, like those guys down at that sleazy newspaper. I read the story this morning. It made me so sick.
No, I didn't read the newspapers. I don't need all of that stuff about Anna resigning as police commissioner because of Duke and the mob.
You know, whatever happened to ethics in reporting?
Well, if it sells five more newspapers, I don't care.
I just hope those turkeys don't turn up at the service and make a lot of fuss. I just might lose my cool and give them a piece of my mind.
I'll get it.
Well, I know.
And if it's anybody from the press, they're going to get my strong right arm.
I can't help you.
Oh, thank heavens it's you.
Who else were you expecting?
Well, the press. You know, you never know. There's a car full of them right outside.
Yeah, could be kind of a mess today. I think I'll run interference for Anna and Robin when they decide to leave.
Where is Anna?
She finally got up the nerve to go into their bedroom and get dressed.
Is she alone? She hasn't been in there since he died.
I know, and I told her to go in the study. I'd bring her clothes, but...
Shouldn't somebody be with her?
I know. She said she wanted to face it now.
You want to get fishing? Okay, we'll go fishing.
No. On third thought, the fish can wait. For a little while.
Wear black to funerals and memorials, but do you think Uncle Duke would mind if I wore this?
No, sweetheart. I think he'd really like it.
You've been. What have I told you about punctuality? I've been in here answering the phones all morning. What kind of a job do you think you got here?
It's 10 o'clock. I work from 10 to 5:30. Have you got a problem with that?
Never mind. Look, here's what I want you to do. I want you to find out about this guy. I want you to call the police, the local police, his hometown police, anything you know about Woodrow Wilson Malone.
Oh, yeah, the sleaze who set up Duke Lavery.
Yeah, well, up to now he's been living the life of a Boy Scout, and all of a sudden, boom, something goes haywire. Something is fishy here, and I want to know what's going on. So just do it.
Please?
Please.
That's better. Excuse me. Here you are. Good morning.
Good morning. Hey, you look good in black. Very sexy.
Oh, well, thanks. This is my go-to-funerals and memorial services dress. Did you forget you're supposed to take me to Duke's service today?
No, I didn't forget. I'm not going to the funeral. They give me the willies.
Oh, wait a minute. You are going. You know, Anna is expecting everybody in town to be there, even us.
Yeah, well, I can do more for Duke and Anna by staying here and trying to put Victor Jerome behind bars.
Scott, look, the police are working on that, and that hero of everyone, Scorpio, is doing the same thing. Come on.
Well, that's because it's her ex-husband.
Come on, Scott. It's 2 hours out of your life, and are you forgetting there will be very important, influential people there? Yes?
You got a point.
Good.
So why don't you put a hat on and cover it up? I'll go. A loud tie and all.
Oh, no. Guess what? I know your taste very well, so I brought you a more appropriate tie.
Good.
Taste the tie.
Yeah, I better get it. It's important.
I've got it. You go on. I got you. Come on, let's go, please.
She did something.
Go. Mr. Baldwin's office.
Hello. Yes, I'd like to know if Mr. Baldwin received something that I mailed to him yesterday. It's very important.
Oh, no, he hasn't gotten any mail yet. It's not due in for another couple of hours. If you want to give me your name and your phone number, I'll call you when he gets it.
No, thank you. There's no need. I'll call back.
Hi. It's amazing what you people can do getting my cleaning back to me so soon.
They owed me a few.
Thank you. Keep on all, yes.
Thank you.
Bye. Thank you so much. Nora? Nora?
Here you go. Here's some cream and
sugar. Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Just what?
Have some more coffee.
Oh, thank you, Owen. How's Anna doing?
Well, she's hanging in there, hurting deep, but head held high.
Well, she's very strong, that's for sure.
I'll get that.
Morning. Princess, how's Anna doing?
She's in the bedroom.
Robin?
Oh, she's with Anna. Why don't you have a seat, and I'll get you some coffee.
Morning, Olin.
Morning.
Morning.
Standing straight.
How's everything here, honey?
It is a nightmare, Sherman, a nightmare.
Catherine and I were talking a little while ago about our trip to Los Angeles. I guess she told you.
Yeah, something about a display or something like that.
Yeah, it's just a collection of my Egyptian artifacts from my dig last year.
Really? Well, I guess I should be checking on the ladies, excuse me.
Hi.
Hello, everybody. Hello. Hi.
Thanks for coming. Hi.
Hi. Naya. See you again.
Okay. You look great.
You look fine, love. Okay. I hope you haven't read the papers this morning, in particular the Gazette.
No, I would read that. It's rubbish.
You and Robin have become grist for the mill, which is why I want to take you in the back entrance where I can cordon off the alley.
No. They don't think they've won.
I don't care what they think. I care about you two.
All right, we'll do it for her. Do it for Robin.
You know, Lavery was a lucky man to have had you for the limited time that he did. Well, I'm sure you'd agree with me.
Excuse me, Daddy. It's for Mom.
Oh, darling.
Do you remember what Uncle Duke always used to say? That Heather had such a short life, just in the spring? Well, there's one for you. And there's one for me.
Sweetheart.
I bought them myself. I ordered them and paid for them.
You better go.
Yeah.
Everybody?
Thank you.
Who is it?
Lydia, it's Dr. Hardy. I'm checking in.
Oh, just a minute, Dr. Hardy. Just one minute, please. Just a minute. Hi, Dr. Hardy. Why didn't you? I thought you would always call me.
I tried, but your line was busy.
Oh, really? It must have been the hotel switchboard. I haven't been on the phone. I have no one to call.
Am I interrupting anything?
Well, actually, I do have plans for today, unfortunately. I'm supposed to go see a new young artist with Nora.
Sounds interesting.
Well, it will be if he's any good.
Well, I really don't know much about that. Just wanted to stop by and see how you're doing. Let me talk for a minute. Reminds me of Europe. Can you imagine bicycling through Europe with three guys? No, we went down to Italy. It was so beautiful down there. Have you ever been to Florence? Such a beautiful
Tom,
place.
Tom, could we cut the chit-chat and get to the reason why you really came?
I came to see you.
Tom, I remember all the questions that everyone asked me. I read all the newspaper articles about what happened to me that night right here in this hotel. I know that my father was meeting with some of the top mob bosses and that I was supposed to be presented or something. It's not clear.
Olivia, I'm not asking you about any of that.
Oh, well, then what are you asking me? Whether or not I remember Anna Devane actually coming in here and trying to shoot me, or my half-brother Dino actually doing it?
Well, not that either.
Good. Then let me tell you the absolute and final truth about what I remember happened that night.
Go on.
Nothing.
Nothing.
That's what I remember. Nothing. I can envision that night from what I've been told, what I've read. I get a hazy picture, but it's nothing that I know about. You don't believe me, do you?
Why do you say that?
Because I'm constantly being told that I'm only pretending that I can't remember.
I've never told you that, Olivia. As far as I'm concerned, the only thing that matters to me is you and your health.
I'm sorry. I know that you're not accusing me yourself. It's just... Can you imagine what it's like trying to recover from an illness and get on with your life when people are constantly telling you that you've done things that you can't even remember happened?
No. I couldn't imagine that. Doesn't sound like a whole lot of fun to me either.
No, it's not.
Now, listen, I've got to get shaking. I'm already late for a memorial service.
Oh, well, don't let me keep you.
Since I'm already late, why don't I give you Nora a lift? You are going to see a young artist. Five will get you 10, that he lives in the dock area, loft area down by the dock.
Well, that's very nice. No, he doesn't. He lives across town. Thank you.
Well, I try. I'll check with you tomorrow.
Okay, all right.
Okay, I'll see you later.
Thank you, and I look forward to seeing you.
All right, you have a nice afternoon.
Okay, bye now. Yes, this is Olivia Jerome in room 954. Please hold all of my calls. I will get my messages later. No exceptions. Thank you.
Hey, DeBoer, how did it feel to shoot your sweetie's cousin last month?
I was defending my fiancée's life.
Well, how come Althea was trying to kill her in the first place?
Listen, you sawed off... Excuse us. Come on.
Hold that. Not one of you dudes is fit to shine his shoes.
Anna, how's it feel to lose all that big money the mob was sending you?
There ain't any bread at all.
What was Duke's relationship with Victor Jerome's daughter, was that like just one of the perks of this business?
Why don't you... Right.
Hey, nothing personal, Commissioner. We just want the lady to know that all of Port Charles is behind her. The bum is dead. We know how much better off...
Hey, look, whatever you thought of my husband, it doesn't give you license to behave this way.
It's my job.
No, your job is as a decent human being. You've lied to the people of Port Charles, and if they'd known the truth, they would never have behaved this way.
Excuse me, but the truth is that he was involved with the mob.
No,
yes,
no. Why don't you come in and listen to the truth?
Honey, you don't want this lot inside.
Hey, I'm willing to listen.
Then you can write anything you damn well please.
I want them to come into the service. You owe it to yourselves to listen.
What else am I doing this
for? All right, one condition. No wisecracks and no dumb questions. Remember the occasion and try to behave accordingly.
Are you implying that the press don't have any manners, Commissioner?
That's about the size of it.
Let's go in, please.
Oh, come on.